I thought, wouldn't it be exciting to communicate with a chimp and find out what it was thinking? So why not teach him sign language? And that's essentially why I started Project NIM.
I know nothing about chimpanzees. Herb wanted me to take NIM into my home as if he were a child. The fact that we could share language with an animal seemed very radical at that time.
There was no family discussion. It was just, oh, we're having a chimp. We're going to teach a sign language. Nobody in the house really was fluent in sign language.
Everything was about treating him like a human being. He liked alcohol. He loved driving fast in cars. I breastfed him for a couple of months. It seemed completely natural.
I couldn't believe it.
It was the 70s.
Herb wanted a schedule and charted progress. I didn't supply that.
There was utter chaos. There were no journals. There were no logbooks. This was a scientific project.
I had an implicit faith that NIM would learn signs.
I just mapped out a teaching plan for NIM, and I did it. NIM was learning signs rapidly. They're going up, 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 up. I could see I was succeeding. There was all this excitement and hype about the project.
I had a relationship with a chimpanzee, and I had conversations with another species.
NIM gone from being this meek little huggable toy to a robust young chimpanzee.
He's going to be big, 5 to 6 times the strength of a man.
He's got fangs.
This is 37 stitches.
In that sense, he was becoming more chimp-like. It didn't seem to be a cause for alarm. I had never regarded him as a child. I regarded him as a scientific project. Nobody keeps a chimp for more than 5 years.
I had the best time of my life. I've never had such a good time. Except maybe at a Grateful Dead show.
The reality of it is it's not a doll, it's not a toy, it's not a human, it's a chimp.